Dave in Manchester says, I can't believe Darnell chose to put Rex in heaven after he nominated him. Darnell is such a two-faced game player. Get him out. So, do we agree? Is he a game player?
He is? Of course he is.
He is?
Yeah. He is, definitely. I just don't agree with the way he plays the game as well. It's just so simple and everybody can see it from outside. Yes. I think they need to open their eyes inside the house a little bit more.
Okay, right, so we've got some unseen footage. Let's have a look at how Luke celebrated his birthday in the Big Brother house earlier today.
As today is Luke's 21st birthday,
you know it.
Big Brother is going to throw him a birthday party in the wine cellar.
21. Awesome.
There will be four guests at Luke's birthday party.
Mm-hmm.
Two housemates from hell,
mm-hmm.
one of whom should be Luke, and two heavenly housemates.
Yeah.
Cheese.
Baguettes.
There's a lot. Why is there a light there?
We have to eat this. I knew we'd have to eat this. I told you.
Baguettes.
Yeah, good.
So we can sing some happy birthday. Finish, Joe.
Let's come on, get quiet. Get
some candles. Oh, yeah, light the candles. That's what it's for. What's the thing?
What?
That's what it's for. Light the candles. That's what the light is for.
Yeah, light the candles.
Those are the cold welcome packs.
Seriously, happy birthday. Yeah.
Celebrating his birthday. Are the audience pleased that he's enjoying his birthday in the Big Brother house? Yeah. Are you pleased he's enjoying his birthday?
Yeah, he should be able to have a laugh.
It's his 21st, it's a big one, isn't it?
Yeah, he's a bit out of order being in hell and that on his 21st. He should be able to get pissed with his friends.
Absolutely. Cool. Okay, for this week's shopping task, Big Brother has set the hellish housemates the challenge of a cycle distance between Paris and Madrid. All they've got to do is sit there and pedal, but they keep complaining that it hurts their arseholes. So, in the name of the big mouth science, we want to find out just how hard that is. Over the break, this fella is going to cycle the distance from the studios to Milton Keynes. Get going, fatty. We'll see you in a bit. Tonight are weather girl Lara Lewington and Sam Delaney from The Guardian. And last week, Big Wig to E4 sent us a wheelbarrow full of money to improve the health and safety of our shoddily put together studio. But we thought, up yours, we're going to spend the money on a massive robot.
Greetings, Earthlings. My name is Kevin, and I have come to find out what the humanoids think about Big Brother.
Which housemate needs rewiring?
Lisa.
Lisa, she's a man.
Will you do the robot with me?
Yeah, how?
The robot dance. That's a very good robot. Which housemate needs terminating?
Oh my God, Bex, definitely. She's just a Coventry chav and she needs to go home.
Which housemate needs rebooting out of the house?
Mo, because he's always moaning about meat.
Will you dance the robot with me? Which housemate is most likely to short circuit? You have 10 seconds to comply. Which housemate would you most like to oil?
Sarah.
He fancies a bit of Sarah.
Will you oil me down?
No. You sound a bit manly for us. See you later, robot, yeah?
Goodbye.
Data collected. End transmission.
One sexy robot. In this part of the show, we're going to answer a load of questions pulled out of the Big Mouth post bag. Wouldn't it be great if we had a postman here to deliver them?
Yeah! Letter for Miss Gascoigne.
It's me!
Hey!
haven't you got a big shiny sack? What's the first topic?
Okay. Should housemates who whinge and complain about brother be removed?
Sam.
Yeah,
what do
chuck
you
think? Them out. No, actually, that's ridiculous. It's the whole point of the show is to watch people whinge in an imaginative way. You can't throw everyone out of an empty house. Be a void.
Laura, what do you think about the whingers?
I think you should definitely keep them in. I don't want to see everyone happy all the time. I want to see them suffer.
Of course you do. Next topic, Posty.
What is there to like about Darnell?
Everything. What do you like about Darnell?
I love Darnell. I like the way everyone's going over it. Oh, he's a game player. He couldn't be less of a game player. He's so open in the fact. He's so open. He makes his decisions. He sticks to his decisions. He's a maniac, but he's a brilliant maniac.
Yes.
We love him.
Okay. Are you a Darnell fan?
What is there not to like? He gets so excited, but he's like a cute little kid.
Do you like his singing, his rapping? Do you think he's any good?
Yeah, I do think he's good.
I think he's pretty good myself.
He's a nice housemate. He keeps himself out of trouble, so I don't see how anyone could not like him.
Fair enough. Right. Next topic, please, Posty.
Is there any housemate that won't get booed in the eviction?
Ah, good question, Posty. Right. So, audience, who will survive the booing?
I think, well, as you've just said, Darnell will survive the booing. Catrea will probably survive the booing.
No one will really boo her. She's so cute. Who else?
I think most of the others will quite rightly get pantomime booed.
And who would you most like to see booed?
Dale. I don't like him.
Oh, you don't like Dale? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Not at all.
Do you think he's fit?
He's not my type. Nah. Do you know what? I think it should be Rex. I think Rex should be evicted on Friday. Nah. Definitely.
No.
He's
not.
These guys
over
him earlier. I said he was playing.
Sam. Sam, would you boo Darnell?
Darnell? No. I'm his biggest fan. I'm going to try and sign him up and be his Svengali when he comes out there. I won't be booing him. I'll be waving a contract in his face.
Who would you like to boo then?
I would boo Rex. I don't really like Luke. I've gone off him a bit. He's got like a whiny little milksop. And when I saw him having his like birthday, his rubbish birthday party, the theme of which appeared to be French bread, rubbish. Yes. So get drunk on your 21st, not binge on French bread, right? And he looked like a chuckle brother and sounded one more. Never that silly old moustache he had on. I've gone off
Laura,
him.
Laura, who would you most like to boo?
Well, definitely not Rex. I've got to say, I've heard this Rex point
like
over
Rex,
here.
You're a Rex fan,
I want Rex to win. No. I actually think he's
Rex to win. They said he was playing, he's got a game plan. I don't think he's got a game plan at all. All he does is sit on his ass and thinks that he's good enough to win it just by being him. And I really think that he's a bit of a big head.
But Next
topic then, please, Posty.
Are Rachel and Rex the two most intelligent housemates?
Right, so what do you think? Hang on, let me come and sit here. They're here. OK, right, what do we think?
Rex.
Are the most intelligent?
Well, you have to be active to be intelligent. Rex is lazy, so not really intelligent. Rachel, maybe. Rachel, maybe.
Okay, so who do you think is the most intelligent housemate then?
Well, probably Darnell, because he always knows everything. It's very psychological.
He is, isn't he? Oh, yeah, I totally agree with you on that one. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Who do you think is the least intelligent housemate? Oh, we come right over here. Right, come in between you. Two, who do you think?
I think it's got to be Bex.
I think so as well.
The only thing she does know, the only thing that is intelligent in her eyes is food.
Which housemates do we want to stay until the end?
Darnell, but who do you think?
Luke and Darnell.
Luke and Darnell, Anyone else apart from Luke and Darnell? You want Bex to stay?
Rex.
Rex, sorry. Right. So do you like a bit of Rex?
Yeah, I think Rex is really funny.